Hi. In this video, I would like to talk something about my videos. Because I had one question from my subscriber who asked me to make a video on ASR for R129 early models without diagnostics. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button super thanks. And if you, yeah, you, want to be the first one to watch my video as it is fully uploaded, then hit the button join. Thanks. To tell you the truth, in order to make such video, I have literature on that, and there are some 37 pages.
What?
So it would be boring.
What did you say?
So really, once again, I can make that video, but that would be a bare boring theory. And out of that video, you're going to learn absolutely nothing. And that's why I don't want to shoot videos like that. I make theoretical videos, practical videos, but in my theory, I want you to learn something from my video, and that's the point. For example, as I was making the video on EZL, there you could learn how everything functions, how, for example, EZL itself creates ignition, it adjusts itself, the timing, it has its sensors, and if there is something that can make your car, your W124, 6, any of these, if it can make it stop and not run again, it's called the camshaft position sensor. If that part fails on your car, then your car stops there, period. But if I choose, for example, a video to make about that part, I can tell you that the nominal value for that part, in order to check it, is from 650 up to 1200 ohms. Yes. And that's the way how to check it. And that's a useful video. So long story short, I don't like to make boring videos without any point. If I made this video on ASR, then you would learn absolutely nothing. Concerning ASR, for those that don't know what it is, it's the further development of the ABS. The ABS is related to braking, where as you press the brake pedal, then the caliper brakes like this. So periodical braking, let's say, and not like this, to simply press and not to release again the rotor, as on older cars that do not have ABS. And this ASR is related to the throttle. So this is how it looks like. Long story short, you have four sensors for each of the wheel. You have the electronic throttle and the electronic accelerator. That's everything. There are some more parts, some more actuators there, but this is crucial. So what happens if you press the accelerator harder and the wheel starts spinning? Then the system wants to make this wheel turning slower. And in order to do that, it activates the brakes. Now, the ASR module, ECU, then sends signal to the throttle. The throttle then closes, and the more the throttle closes, then the less air you have. As you have less air, you have less fuel. And that's the way how you lose torque. As you lose torque, you lose speed. The car starts decelerating, so going slower. And that's everything. In my literature, everything I could find, it was that you have those sensors, you have an actuator or something that gives nominal value. How much? It doesn't say. For example, let's watch the video on my coolant temperature sensor here, the card. There, I gave you nominal values for this part. As for throttle position sensor, there are nominal values also. And you know how to check that part. As for example, there, this camshaft position sensor. There are nominal values also, and then you know how to check that part. And here, it doesn't say how much those values are. It doesn't say how to check the sensors. It doesn't say how to check the ECU. It doesn't say how you check the electronic throttle. Well, why should I be making a video like that? For you to listen and to get bored of me speaking nonsense. Well, that's why I didn't want to make that video. So this is something, this is a summary of everything. I have read all those 37 pages, and as for me, I learned nothing, absolutely nothing about that ASR. I know that there is ASR1 and ASR2, two versions. The second one was from February 1990, something like that. So, long story short, many data and useless. I want my videos to not to be useless. I want you to learn out of my videos. And for example, let's take the O2 sensor. The O2 sensor, you check the way you disconnect it, and the negative lead of your multimeter goes to the ground, and the positive goes into the signal. You have to get around 450 millivolts. If the voltage is over 900, extremely rich mixture. If it is below 200 something, like 100 millivolts, extremely lean. But the point is that you cannot adjust the sensor itself. You must simply replace it. And there, that's something useful. But this, if I start telling you now, you have this actuator, you have then blah blah blah, this electronical accelerator, you have the sensors. You have the sensors, but there are no values how to check them. For example, you start the car, you turn the ignition on, and the light goes on for the ASR. You start the car, the light simply goes out. And why? What? What about that? That's it for now. I hope you get the picture. I hope you have understood what I wanted to say. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing. Bye.